My career actually started in education at the Lagos Business School as a research assistant. Had the pleasure of working with four amazing people. So first, Professor Albert Alos, to whom I'm eternally grateful for giving me that first opportunity. Then with a gentleman who's still one of my friends and mentors today, Doyin Salami, Yinka David West and Chris Ogbeche. So in that role, I wrote a number of case studies, just generally interrogating how businesses operate in Nigeria, how to build from a small business to a pretty large business, etc. So that sort of helped me prepare for a career in research, which is how I started off my banking career. And then later on, I went to run SME banking. And then fortuitously, I ended up working for the Lagos State Government. So it's been very interesting, but I always feel like every job or every opportunity I've had has prepared me very well for the next one. So it's been a fairly easy progression from education to finance and now to public service. I like to differentiate politics and public service, right? So because you don't necessarily have to be a public politician to work, to serve the people. And I think that I realized that a career in public service was the next step. When, you know, we were all very politically active. I've always been politically active. I've always been a member of a political party. I've always looked forward to voting in an election. I particularly remember the elections of 1993. I was 14 at the time, and I felt like I was missing out, just standing by the ballot, by the polling booth, seeing my parents, you know, and older people in the community actually going to cast their votes. Now remember, that's the first election I ever saw, right? So it was an exciting experience, you know, just being there standing and just watching people vote. I was there the whole day. Obviously, I lived in the University of Lagos, so it was a fairly sheltered environment, you know, where there was no risk of any ballot boxes being snatched, etc. I would say that my first political experience was in university, was in undergrad. I helped my friend who was running for the financial secretary of a faculty body, you know, win that election. And then subsequently, I helped two friends win their elections into the student union as president of the student union. So I always say that one of my claims to fame is that at my time at University of Lagos, you know, two of my friends became student union presidents. So that was like my first, that was my introduction into politics. And it was something that I found very exciting. And over time, I have come to realize that if our best people don't go into public service, then as a society, there's a very, you know, there's limits to how we can evolve and develop. So it's great for everyone to do their businesses, etc. We're not saying everybody should jump into public service, but we need some of our better people in public service. We need people who are alive to the selflessness that's required in public service, who are alive to the fact that our country is not where it's supposed to be, who are alive to the fact that this isn't how things should be. And I think for me, it was a great opportunity to at least walk the talk. You know, if we've been criticizing government over and over again and nothing has changed, you know, some of us at least have to go there and say, can this thing be done? You know, without all the criticisms, you know, you can't put government on its toes. So some of us now have to go in there and say, hey, you know what? We've criticized government for many years. You guys tell us how difficult this stuff is. Maybe it's time for some of us to come and experience it, understand it better, and hopefully also inspire the next generation of leaders. I've always been a political animal. So I told you about my, you know, June 12, 1993 experience where, you know, just watching people go out to vote. I followed the debates. It was also helpful that one of my neighbors was an active member of the Social Democratic Party. So he was there supporting Chief MK Abiola at the time. I was a big fan of the SDP, followed the elections till the annulment, you know, followed all of the pro-democracy activism that followed thereafter. And I was also very lucky that my father was all you might call a human rights and pro-democracy activist. So he was very active in things like the Committee for Defense of Human Rights, Civil Liberties Organization, etc. So, you know, ASU and all of that stuff. So I was born into what you might call the struggle. So it was helpful for me. You know, I read I always joke with my friends that, you know, when I was like 10, you know, you guys were probably reading like Famous Five and Secret Seven. You know, I was reading stuff like Soza Boy. I was reading Festus Iyayi, Ken Sarowiwa, who remains one of my favorite authors. You know, so the kind of books I read were very politically inclined. You know, I very early on was reading Wole Soyinka, etc. So, I mean, I used to wonder why my father bought me those books. But today, you know, I can see the big picture, and I'm very thankful for that lesson very, very early on. My father always said to me, "Remember the son of whom thou art." And for me, it was a very early part of my political development. It was accountability, you know, integrity. Those were critical formative elements that have stayed with me till today. You know, I always say to my colleagues, whether it's in Lagos or in Ekiti, that look, I don't want to be the first Oyebode to go to EFCC, right? I was bequeathed a very strong legacy. It's a legacy that I only want to improve upon and hand over to the next generation. So that foundation was very important, and it stayed with me till today. Because when you go into public service and politics, you always have difficult decisions. You will always be faced with trade-offs. You know, there will be things that will test your integrity. You know, you must always go to bed knowing that with the information I have, I took the best decision I could. And for me, I think that foundation has been very important. It's helped me at least retain a moral compass. You know, I always say that I'm not naive, but I always want to have that moral compass. I always want to say, have I crossed the line? Am I about to cross the line? You know, is this something that Akin will normally not approve of? Why am I doing this? You know, when I see the options, you know, put in front of me, I need to be able to say these ones don't sit with who I am. And so that foundation, I think, is the most important thing in my political journey. One of the things I've learned in my career is I take it one step at a time now. So if you asked me 10 years ago, you know, what I wanted to be, I'll say to you that I definitely wanted to run a financial institution, a bank, right? But someday, you know, I did some work for a gentleman called Akintunde Oyebode. And when I finished that, I thought, well, that's done. I've done that. On to the next. And then one day he called me and said, hey, you know, this employment trust fund that you talked to me about, you know, this thing that, you know, you helped me refine, you kept on arguing with me about, I need someone to run it. So I said, okay, no problem. Tell me who you want, you know, the kind of people I'll help you look for. He's like, no, I want you to run it. So I said to him, hey, you know, I'm not ready for public service. You know, I like my banking. I'm happy to be a party member, chipping from the outside. You know, if you need a brain trust, I'm there to sort of provide some ideas. And he said to me, you know, this is the thing about young people. You speak, you go on Twitter, you go on Facebook, and then you get asked to come to jump into the furnace. And then you say, hey, you know, this stuff is too hot. You know, I want to sit outside. So I always say that he blackmailed me into taking the job. But I took the job and here we are. So again, you know, it's one of those things where if you asked me in 2014, are you going to end up in government? And I've said no. Running for office wasn't like my big thing. You know, people tease me about it now and again. But if the opportunity presents itself, if it's the right opportunity, yeah, sure, why not? But, you know, no one can tell. One of the things that I always tell people, though, is that those who tend to actively seek public office rarely get what they're looking for. My parents clearly have influenced my career choices. Well, more recently. So I like to say that, for example, my father and I sat on very different ideological divides for a very long time. But it's very interesting that I'm somewhat following in his footsteps. So many years ago, he went off first to become the Dean of Law at the University of Ado-Ekiti, and then later became Vice Chancellor. And I remember when he was there, I thought it was a waste of his time. Like, you know, he left his family in Lagos, went off to help Ekiti State develop, and I only got to see him every other weekend, you know. So I find it very interesting that I am now also now that father whose kids see him once in 2 weeks. It was a very difficult decision for me when I was offered the role. And I remember very, very early on, then speaking to then governor-elect and current governor of Ekiti State, Dr. Kayode Fayemi, and I said to him that, look, I don't think I can do this because my wife, my kids, you know, I dropped my kids off in school every morning. You know, it was our ritual. I drop them off in school, I go off to work, you know. That balance is very, very important. It's difficult. I won't say it's easy. I won't advise anyone who doesn't have to do it to try it, but I mean, we're making it work somehow. It's important that we get people in public service from early on, from as young as possible. You know, people have organized in their 20s. People have run for student union president and student union executive in their 20s. There is no reason why we should not get young people into the very highest levels of public service. So I'm very excited about the successes of Not Too Young to Run. I'm very excited to see a number of young people in government today. What is now important is for those people to show that age is not a limiting factor. It's for their performance to also then encourage more young people to take up active service. My name is Akintunde Oyebode. I'm the special advisor to the governor of Ekiti State on investment, trade, and innovation. And this is my first.